you did very well, but many of you did not.
Aw, man!
The addition of fractions is very simple. Let's run through it again. How do we solve this first one?
Add together the 3 and the 3.
Good, Butters. We add the 3s together. And what about the 4s? Token?
They're the denominators, so they stay a 4.
Wait, Token got an A, but I cheated off Token.
I can't hear you, Eric.
I said something's wrong. I got an F, but I cheated off Token.
Yes.
Active shooter! Active shooter!
And
now we divide, right? Craig, how about you? What are we dividing?
Divide 4 by 6?
The 4 by the 6? Or the 6 by the 4?
The 6 by the 4!
Southwest classroom clear!
Now we're gonna retake the exam on Friday.
Shooters in the hallway! All units report!
I'm giving you an opportunity to do better! I hope you take advantage of it!
You can see where Token erased his answers and wrote in the right ones! He did it to me on purpose!
Eric, that's enough!
Shooter is down, shooter is down!
Now let's move on to the next equation.
That is such bullshit, you guys! Token knew I was cheating off of him, so he deliberately put down the wrong answers! Why would he do that?
I flunked that test, too. I don't understand fractions. They don't make any sense.
That's not the point, you guys. Why is Token out to get me? There's something going
on here.
Another
school shooting today has left students in shock and disbelief.
Yeah, Token's probably sick of you cheating off of them all the time.
But why now? That's the question, Kyle. I always cheat off Token. Why did he choose now to hurt me?
Stanley! Stanley, oh my God! Baby! Oh, you're okay!
Hey, Mom.
It's all right, Stanley. We're gonna go home and talk about this with your dad, and we will get through this as a family. Come on, get in the car.
Dude, what's up Stan's mom's ass?
Stanley, well, do you want to tell your father about what happened at school today?
I flunked my math quiz.
No, the other thing!
What other thing? What happened at school today?
Oh, the school shooting?
Yes, the school shooting!
Oh yeah, some kid shot up the school.
Who shot up the school? Was it you?
No.
Did you get shot?
No.
Oh. Well, what's this about failing a math quiz?
Are you serious? Did you not hear what your child said? Kids died at his school!
I'm sorry, Sharon,
Why are you all acting like this is normal? What is wrong with you people?
What's up, Mom?
To be able to voice his concerns. Go ahead, Eric.
Token, there are some terrible things that I realize you might have heard from the other kids here at SKU. There's some rumors that have been going around about me that I thought Black Panther was a terrible movie. There's rumors that I said it was a structural mess, you know, that the rhinos were really stupid. I want to assure you that I never said anything like that. I loved Black Panther. So if, you know, you feel like there's a need to come after me, to get back at me, I just need you to know that people are lying. Because I liked Black Panther just as much as you did. I am not a racist.
I actually never saw Black Panther.
Say what, girlfriend? What you talking about, Willis? Come on, Rush! Oh.
We have to ask ourselves why this is happening and do something now!
Well, you know, Sharon, I think it is a complex issue, you know. It's not really as simple as just... What I'm saying is that with issues like this, sometimes you have to be kind of... crazy?
What are you talking about? Do you understand that our children are being murdered?
Red?
How much closer to home can this all hit? It was at our children's school!
Crazy time. Crazy red time.
I agree with my wife.
I keep thinking, when will be the time that I get the call, you know? When will I answer the phone and find out my son, my daughter, were killed at school?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see.
I live in constant fear that I won't be there to protect my children when something happens to them.
Well, Sharon, have you maybe considered that your feelings are partly due to... handkerchief balls?
What?
Handkerchief balls. Handkerchief out the balls. Red handkerchief. No more handkerchief. No more red. Zero. Empty. Old lady.
What I'm saying is that I'm so overwhelmed that I...
Old lady, where's my dick? Where's my dick?
What the hell are you talking about? I don't understand. God damn it!
Oh, thanks there, Randy. You got it. Where's Josie? Oh, she slipped her disc in her neck. Poor thing can barely move. Oh, she's gonna miss church? That's too bad. Give her my best. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that whoever believed in him should have eternal life. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's gospel talks about what the Lord has to give us. He did so because we could not control our temptations.
Kind of like a priest in a room full of naked boys.
Okay, let's try and have none of that today. In John 3:16, the gospel tells us how God so loved the world, he gave to us his only son.
And a Catholic priest raped him.
Okay. Come on, guys. Now, what greater gift could the Lord have given to us?
Children's underwear, which priests couldn't pull down so easily?
Okay, let's try and compose ourselves. Let's try and just get through this first one, okay, guys? What does it mean that the Lord gave us his only begotten son?
It means if you're a cute boy at a Catholic priest swimming party, you better be getting...
Today, I'd like to talk on the subject of penance. The penitent have deep remorse, but for true penance, we must be humble enough to admit that the Lord's forgiveness is undeserved.
Kind of like how getting raped by a Catholic priest is undeserved.
In Job 42:6, we read, "Therefore I reprehend myself and do penance in dust and ashes."
And in choir boys, butts, and asses.
So we are not to punish ourselves, but instead, we are to make ourselves passionate.
Like a Catholic priest at a Chuck E. Cheese. Oh, darn, get out of my faith back.
Passionate to understand all that Christ sacrificed and how hard it truly was.
How hard what truly was?